Hello, another video from my series of, in my opinion, underrated albums. Today it's about the great Scottish, legendary Scottish group duo, the Jesus and Mary Chain, two brothers, William and Jim Reid. They formed in the early 80s, and in the beginning were like more feedback heavy version of the Ramones with a pessimistic, cynical Scottish twist on it, I would say. In the early lineup, there was also the drummer was Bobby Gillespie, who later would form Primal Scream, another great Scottish indie band from the late 80s until now. But he left the band in the before the album came out that we're talking today about. He left the band in the late 80s to focus more on the great band that is to this day is Primal Scream. Various other lineup changes with bass players and drummers. But today we're talking about an infamous album without a bass player and without a drummer. The Reid brothers, like the Gallagher brothers, like the blueprint from the Gallagher brothers, they had like the same manager or same. Not manager, Alan McGee, also from Scotland. He was the guy who discovered the Jesus and Mary Chain and who formed the image, not so nice, very punkish image of, they also had in the beginning they played like 20-minute shows that have where fights would start, often fights between the two brothers on stage, and so it was a very wild band with a wild image, and Al McGee was responsible for that image. And later, when he formed the indie label Creation, he was of course the guy who signed Oasis, and the image of Oasis, I think, was a bit formed after the blueprint that Jesus and Mary Chain were so also influential in that sense, the band. But back to the album we want to talk about. Today's album is underrated and wasn't successful at the time because, or one of the reasons is because, like I said, the brothers, the Reid brothers, weren't often, didn't have the image of nice people, especially at the time with all the drugs. So everyone left the group, so they were on their own. There was no bass player, no drummer. So they decided that the third album, Automatic, which is the album we're talking about today, Automatic from 1990, 1989, sorry, they would record it as a two-piece. And drum computers at that time and bass synths weren't really up to today's standards. Still today, I don't like the sound of that. But at that time, to today's ears, but even back then, it sounded very cheesy. The cheap drum computing sounds and the synth bass they played instead of real musicians. There's one song with real drums, "Gimme Hell," which is one of the weaker tracks on the album. But all the other songs have this feel of those two crazy Scottish brothers playing, very loud, distorted e-guitars, and then synth bass and cheap drum computer on top of it. So it's a very weird sounding, a very unique sounding album. The albums before, which were in an indie sense very successful, Psycho Candy and Darklands, they were also very, I wouldn't say experimental, but very atonal at times, very cacophonic with lots of feedback. You really had to listen very carefully to find that there's a re that there are really great melodies. I think they are great songwriters, the Reid brothers, but it was buried under that loud wall of guitar sound. And Automatic also has the loud guitar sound, plus, like I said, the rhythm section, which was very a strange synthetic one. But that, and it flopped because of that. The albums before, in an indie way, were successes. The critics liked them. This album at the time when it came out was panned, but it should be rediscovered. There are so many great songs on this album. Here comes a Alice, Coast to Coast, Blues from a Gun. My favorite Jesus and Mary Chain song is song number 4, Between Planets. What a great two-tone guitar solo. Probably one of the most simple but most effective guitar solos of all time. Head On, which was a single, you know, single but not a big hit. Funnily enough, David Hasselhoff, of all people, has made a cover of Head on his last album. Very strange. But a good cover. Strange. Halfway to Crazy is maybe the most commercial sounding song on this really wild album. Again, great melody, you know. They really were good songwriters. The vinyl version that I never owned, but I read it on Wikipedia. The last song on that is Gimme Hell. But the CD version, which is the only version I ever knew, has two bonus tracks. And one of those bonus tracks is, again, one of my favorite Jesus and Mary Chain songs of all time, the ballad Drop, which is really a relief after that really wild, loud album. Yeah, it's very underrated. I think I prefer it to Darklands, which is the probably most pop-oriented album, and I even prefer it to the big classic Psycho Candy, the debut album, which has, you know, classics like Some Candy Talking, Just Like Honey, which was would become more well-known songs after it was used in the Lost in Translation film by Sofia Coppola. So this is a great album, don't get me wrong. Darklands is also a very good album. They made a couple of albums after that, you know, they split up, reunited, you know, Brothers at War all the time. And they, some of those later albums are also quite good. But my favorite will always be the Black Sheep in the catalog family, which is Automatic, one of the most underrated albums of all time. Thank you for watching.